So check this out. This is the new pen that was sent to me by Sunil at the Good Blue. This is his new creation, the L130. Why is it called the L130? Well, let me show you. So that is definitely one way to let you know how long the pen is. We're going to be going through this, doing some writing samples. There's even some extra nibs. This has a medium, but he also included a broad and this fun little zoom nib. So we'll be going through that. Been using it for over a week now. Got to tell you, I absolutely love this pen. It is designed as a journaling pen, and I can see why. When I first saw it, it didn't, like, I thought it was a neat design, but it didn't really jump out at me and speak to me too much. But now using it and getting it in the hand, I've been going for this pen nonstop. I adore it. So let's run you through it, show you what it's all about, give you some thoughts, and most importantly, write with it. So 130 is the length, 12 millimeters is the diameter. It's made out of an aluminum body, and then the section here is in brass, weighing in at about 32 grams. That's with the converter installed with ink in it as well. The aesthetics are pretty straightforward. What you see is what you get here. Not a whole lot of features to go with, but all the features that are on here are quite nice. We have a little step down here that receives the cap here when you post it. I'll show you that in a second. 12 millimeter body, tiny little taper that goes right here. Nice little radius. All the edges are broken, you know, nothing sharp at all. And then we got the Good Blue logo there on the end. Looks like it's done with a laser or something like that. The cap comes off nice and simple. One turn and then it posts. And let me get you a close-up sound of that posting. I have to tell you, that is one part of the pen that just does not get old at all, is doing that. And the fit is just done so well. You can actually feel the air. You can even see the little air pocket that gets in there. It has some bounce to it. Let me get you up close. I don't know if we can pick it up here, but there's a little air cushion. And see how it pushes back? Okay, now the air is out. Now it goes down. But you can see it's just such a nice slip fit. And that's actually what keeps it on. So the air gets pressed out. So now you have a little low pressure system in here, and that keeps it on there, which just, yeah. It's just let physics do the work for you. You can see if I push it down fast, it bumps back up. So it's really cool to feel that air come out of the back there when you're posting it. You know, you might not get super excited by that, but that it's super cool to me. It just works so well. As far as balance goes, we have a weight bias here to the section from the brass. The brass here, you can see it's like unfinished. So again, I can't show you here on the phone, but you can see just some fine machine lines on there just to give that little bit of texture on there. The color on this one, there's three or four colors. I think this one's called Space Gray. There's an aquamarine blue. There's a British Racing Green. I thought I saw a red one at some point. I can't remember. So he's got some nice color options on there. I really actually like this gray. Normally, that's not a color I would go for. It's tough to pick up on here in the camera, but you might have seen this on some cars. I can't remember if it's Audi or Porsche. They have a gray like this, almost like what I thought was like a battleship gray to go on some of their vehicles. I think it looks quite nice here on the pen, but it just slips on and it's ready to go and it writes. It's a perfect size. It really, really fits in there well. The weight is quite nice. It's just lovely to work with. You know, obviously it doesn't backweight it because it's such a small, light little cap on there. So yeah, however you hold it, if you want to keep the cap off, it's fine as well. Whatever you want to do, it's so fun to write. And on your grip, you can grip high if you're a high gripper or staggered or however you are, it's round. So I don't think anyone is going to have a problem gripping onto it. You got the nice texture from here, no step downs anywhere. The threads are right up here at the very front, right in front of the nib, right behind the nib there at the tip of the section. So that's a nice feature. It, you know, slips on one turn. It's just a single start thread. So depending where the cap and the threads on here line up, you might have to go a little more rotation or you'll just get off a touch, but it does find itself how to go on there quite nice and true. I haven't had any cross threading, but depending if you just missed it, you got to go around like one more time, but then it finds itself and goes on there. And even when you cap it on here, I don't know if it's just a what the feel is, but you could feel an extra little bit of friction, just that last like fraction of a turn, and it just feels really nice in there too. I haven't had any issues whatsoever with dry up of the nib at all. Let's pop the back off here, and here's the converter. It fits on there. There's no O-ring or anything like that. So for all you eyedropper folks, it's a metal pen. There's no O-ring intended to go in here. You got the threads on here, so that receives into the section there. One, this is probably the only little thing with it, is most pens will have like a little bore in here to fit the converter into. We're just going straight onto the end of the feed, onto the nipple there. The reason for that is it's quite a compact design, so you need clearance to fit those threads in there. So I'm not sure if that's something that can happen later. When you put it on, it holds it secure. It is nice and secure. It's not going to fall off, but it does wiggle a little bit because there's nothing that this is sliding into to sort of, you know, keep it in there so you can't wiggle it. So I haven't had any issues with this coming off whatsoever, but you might notice that when you go to fill it, you might think, oh, is something going to happen? It's going to stay on there quite well, but yeah, it does wiggle like that. So I haven't had any issues. I've been using this every day for a lot because I thoroughly enjoy the pen. So there we go. That's it. Like, I don't know what else to show you. It's a very simple design. I figure let's give you a quick size comparison and then just get to the funnest part of this pen, which is writing with it. Really quick, I have my Lamy 2000, my Enso Puma, the L130, and a Pilot Preppy that I found in the drawer that really needs to be cleaned out bad. And now we got the caps off so you can see what it looks like there. So I'll start the writing on this Regalia pad because I just absolutely love Regalia paper. We'll start off with the medium, then we'll go to the broad, and then we'll play around with the zoom nib. Afterwards, what I will do as well is I will add to my list of nib widths so we can see what the broad writes like and the medium. I find this medium writes a little bit more narrow, so that'll be good to put it with the other nibs that I have in the data sheet there and compare. Overall, I have to tell you, writing with this pen is so much fun, and especially with the extra nibs in this zoom nib, I'm still trying to figure this thing out. But yeah, lots of fun working with it. I did some measurements on the nib points going back to my sheets where I compared a whole bunch of different branded nibs. Now, I reached out to Sunil at the Good Blue, and he mentioned, you know, there can be a little bit of variance in it. So this is probably a little bit of a thinner medium. I clocked this one in when I checked it with my calibration slide about 0.4 millimeters. So that puts it like a Japanese medium versus more like a Western medium. But he says they range from about 0.4 to 0.5. So right in that side there. So if you're used to like a thicker medium, this runs a little bit on the thinner side. For the broad, it's right in there. So 0.7 millimeter, which is what I was getting with a Caveco broad, a Yovo broad. So right in that same spot, and it's very nice and juicy. And I did the zoom as well. So I did the cross strokes and the down strokes, so 0.3 millimeter, and of course I smudged it on the cross strokes, fairly upright on the zoom, and then you get about a millimeter on the cross stroke when you're down nice and low, and about 0.7 millimeter on the down stroke there with about the same angle. So you have a little bit of a, I guess, an architect flair to it as well, but you know, 0.3 to 1 millimeter is pretty huge on the same nib. And of course, after all the nib swapping, my hands are getting pretty dark here with ink. But let's wrap this up and tell you what my overall impression of the pen is. I gotta say, I am extremely pleasantly surprised with this pen. I really enjoy it. The second I got it, I thought, oh, that's neat. Then I uncapped it and I did that, and I was just, yeah, it just feels like it's right at home. It just fits in the hand quite well. So the proportions, the dimensions, the weight, the balance, everything is, he probably spent a fair amount of time on this, and it shows. It's extremely comfortable to use. It's a unique design. You know, I haven't seen anything else that really looks too much like this. So I think that's sort of a fun thing as well. It definitely gets your attention as far as being different from the norm that you see out there as well. But then the biggest thing, it performs, and it's been an absolute joy to use, and I will continue to use it daily after the review of this video here. As far as little things I don't like, there's really nothing. The only thing I would say is just that converter, just the way it sits, that's not a problem at all. And like, none of these things are problems, but it does rattle a little bit in there. So if you tap it, there's a little rattle. It doesn't happen, of course, while you're writing, but it does just vibrate and just rattle a little bit if you're tapping the pen. So that's, I'm stretching here, but as far as performance, it's great. It goes on, it hasn't dried out on me, which is huge as well. And I just really enjoy it. The section, that grip, all those details are nice. The posting is good. And I just think it's a really cool looking pen. Something unique, something different. I think on the next iterations, they might look at making it post all the way down, so it just comes up seamless. Like, it doesn't bother me at all. The pen's unique looking as it is, so I don't think that detracts from it. So maybe that might be something they do moving forward. But yeah, I really have zero gripes with the pen whatsoever. I think it's very well built, unique. One pen, many nibs option, which I always think is great. You can put other nibs in here as well. You can fit this with the flex nib. They don't sell it available with the flex nib at the Good Blue, but if you have one or you buy one separately, it will fit in the pen as well. So a big thank you goes out to Sunil at the Good Blue for sending me your new little L130 for review. You're going to want to keep your eyes on the channel because they'll be reviewing the R615 next, and this will be the one that will be given away, so keep tuned on that lovely flex nib. We'll be having fun with that. If you got any questions, comments down below, as always, hit subscribe, and we'll catch you next time.